Hi, and I welcome you to this lecture. In this lecture, I will talk how Dynatrace can be useful for team members with different job roles. Identifying performance issues during the development phase is always recommended instead of dealing with performance issues in QA or post-production phase. Dynatrace can be used by developers to improve the quality of a product during the development phase itself. If you are joining a project as a new team member, you might not find an updated documentation on application design and flow. Under such cases, Dynatrace can help you in understanding the design and flow of your application. If your whole infrastructure is monitored by Dynatrace, then you can easily get a flow diagram of your application by using a feature called SmartCap Topology in Dynatrace. Here, Dynatrace backtracks the flow of your project using the transactions happening between services. It also backtracks the calls made from one process to another process. Gathering all these data, Dynatrace will model the flow of your application and display it for you in a rich user interface. In case your infrastructure is not monitored using Dynatrace, you can make local setup of your application and deploy Dynatrace One agent in your local machine where you have local setup of your application. Then perform some transactions in your local setup. Dynatrace will capture the flow and it will model the application for you. Apart from understanding the flow of your application, you can also use SmartScape Topology to cross-check the design and flow changes you have done to your application. The next scenario where a developer can use Dynatrace is when they want to check the response time of each and every transaction made across their application. If you are trying to performance tune your application, Dynatrace will be a handy tool to check response time of your transactions in application. First thing you have to do is deploy Dynatrace One agent in your local machine where you have local setup of your applications and its dependent components. Then trigger some traffic to your application. Dynatrace One agent will capture all required data and it will pass it on to Dynatrace server. Dynatrace server will process the fetched data and will display it in your Dynatrace console with possible breakdown of response time across your application. Apart from this, developers can also use Dynatrace to debug issues related to application's integrity during code changes. Since Dynatrace can monitor your full-stack application at method level, it can help you in spotting the exact code location where the issue is occurring. With this, you can figure out where exactly your application is breaking. Now you got an idea how Dynatrace can be useful for developers in their development work. Actually, Dynatrace can be even more useful for developers. You can just give a try and figure it out. Next, let's see how Dynatrace can be useful for a QA engineer during testing phase of an application. Dynatrace can be mainly useful for a QA engineer in performance tests. Install Dynatrace One agent in your performance testing environment and start your performance testing by generating traffic. While the test runs, you can do a live full-stack monitoring of your application and infrastructure to find the breaking point. Apart from this, Dynatrace will also help you in finding the exact location where your application is breaking. Parallelly, you can monitor your QA environment when you test your application for defects. If your application crashes or functionally fails, Dynatrace will help you in debugging your application to find the root cause for crash or failure. Before you start testing your application, you can also configure Dynatrace to monitor the log files in the QA environment to look for potential errors which indicates an issue in application. While you perform your testing, Dynatrace will look for errors in your application logs and will alert you with notification once error pops up. I hope now you have a basic understanding on how a QA engineer can start using Dynatrace. In fact, Dynatrace can be useful in many more ways than I mentioned here. Next, let's see how Dynatrace can be useful for a production support, operations, and a DevOps engineer. The answer is almost every features in Dynatrace can be useful for these job roles. Here, I would like to mention few frequent and important ways Dynatrace can be useful for these job roles. Production support, operations, and DevOps are the one who make sure your application is running smoothly in production without any issues. That's the reason why an environment monitoring tool like Dynatrace can be a relic to these people. Dynatrace can monitor complete infrastructure resources, and on detecting any anomaly, Dynatrace can alert you with notification through multiple channels. Apart from this, your application can also be monitored for performance degradation. Dynatrace can monitor the availability of your application across different geographical locations by generating synthetic traffic from across the globe. These are the most appreciated and commonly used features of Dynatrace. It has many more features which helps you to monitor your application and infrastructure. Other than technical teams, Dynatrace can also be useful for management. Management can track sales or subscription of a product by configuring conversion goals in Dynatrace. Conversion goals will keep track of successful payments in your application and will provide you with metrics. This gives an alternate way for management to keep track of revenue generated by a particular product. Apart from this, management can also keep track of underutilized resources in your infrastructure. For example, if a component is just utilizing 5% of CPU and memory, management can track this and request operations team to reduce the resources allocated for that particular application. I hope now you got a basic understanding on how Dynatrace can be useful for people with different nature of work in your project. With this, I conclude my lecture. Thanks for watching this video, and let's meet again in my next lecture.